Estamos con James Paxton, el protagonista de Eyewitness, que ha venido a España para contarnos algunos detalles de su nueva serie, que llega a Calle 13 próximamente. Hi, James. How are you? How is your first day in Spain?
I'm great. It's great. Ayer, mi novia y yo visitamos al Museo del Prado y también del Parque del Retiro. Lo siento. Lo olvido mucho de mi español porque no estoy practicándolo cada día.
But you speak really, really great Spanish.
Thank you. Gracias. Tomé clases de español en el instituto por 4 años.
Okay, the first thing, you are a dark hair boy. What happened with your blonde?
Hey, Rubio? It's gone now. Yeah, I just did another TV show where they wanted me to change the hair color, so that's why, you know, gotta do what you gotta do. But I miss the blonde hair, though. I like the blonde hair.
But it's a script idea, or is it because you want to be blonde?
It was a little bit of both. I wanted to be blonde, but it was also the original character in the Norwegian series was blonde, and I thought it would be a cool, and you know, a lot of people in the motocross world like to dye their hair and stuff like that and stuff, so, and I think it's kind of like an interesting, in a way it's also a little bit of a simbólica to like my character and inside just kind of dealing with like who he is and identity and kind of changing things of aspects about himself, so it's very much on purpose.
I think Lucas is a problematic boy. He's not a typical one. How is Lucas?
Lucas, yes, he's very complex, you know, because he's a young motocross rider. He wants to go pro. That's all he cares about in life. But he's also, so he's kind of this tough kind of kid, macho kid on the outside. But underneath, he's dealing with all these emotions of uncertainty and insecurity and fear and that all kind of arise when this cute boy from New York City comes and meets him, and then they see the murder. So yes, he's very complex.
He tried to stick to the status quo because he's coming from a rich family.
Exactly.
It's getting good grades, good marks at the school. But he felt a little sad because he can't be who he is.
He totally has not come to terms with just loving himself as who he is, and that, you know, he doesn't know love is love. He doesn't know anything else. He's very lived actually a very simple life because motocross is all he's ever wanted to do, and he wants that's kind of his ticket out of the small town. Like you said, he's grew up on the farm with his dad, and he gets good grades, but it's kind of all, he's had a very simple path in his life, and then it all becomes so complicated, you know, as soon as he starts to try to like to even indulge in his attraction with another boy, all of this crazy shit happens, and it's like he almost feels in his own mind like it's this punishment for this sin that he's going through and stuff, and so it's all irrational and inside his mind, but of course, you know, that's his mind is his most dangerous place.
Have you seen the original series?
Yes, I have seen the first two episodes of the original series. The reason being was Tyler, my co-star, and I, we didn't want to watch the original series before we shot at least the first two episodes because we didn't want to feel like we were copying anything, because our show is very much a reimagining of the original. It's very different. It's got similarities, but that show is terrific too, though. We went and watched the next episodes, and I'll finish it. I honestly, it's been so crazy since the show is finished, but those actors are terrific. I know the actor who plays my character, Odin Wage. I'm sorry if I'm saying that wrong. Your name. I'll meet you one day, and you can tell me. He's a really terrific actor and stuff. So I was really like an honor.
Normally, in an adaptation to USA or whatever, there are little differences between the original and the new one. Mm-hmm. Which difference have we got between the original and this one?
Well, I think that because we were a remake, our show had a bit more time to really analyze and go more in depth with the story between the two boys and that core story. There was more to do with us in our story, and as the show goes on, a lot of the other storylines kind of thin out, and it becomes more and more about just kind of us and Julianne and Gil and stuff and the killer. So, it's kind of, you know, so that's the main difference. But then, also towards the end, it goes a totally different place. Because our show is 4 episodes longer than the original, 4 episodes more.
We've seen the first episode yet, and it's crazy, it's really fast. It has that really big cliffhanger at the end. It's all the time like that. It's all the time, all the things happening like that.
Yes, yeah. ¿Cómo se dice? Pacing again? Ritmo? Ritmo, yeah. The ritmo is like muy rápido, porque it's like, it's, you know, solamente tenemos 10 episodios, and entonces it's like, every episode is like really intense and something is happening because we have to fit the whole thing in this one 10 episode story. It's like a really long movie, so yes.
It has that closed ending, the closed finale, or it's really open, the finale of the season?
I can't tell you. I can't tell you.
It could be more story a part of that.
You mean another yeah, season?
Maybe. Well, the story, because maybe the story is...
Yes, there could be. I don't know what the network would do because it's kind of set up as an anthology, like these shows like True Detective and American Horror Story, where it's kind of technically it's ending. But you know, maybe they'll want to bring it back if the fans like it enough. You know, if enough people want to watch it. So hopefully,
I think it's the first series, the first movie that you are that you are like a main character.
The first TV show for me.
Show?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How is working in TV different than the movie? Yeah.
Yeah, it's very different actually. It's what I loved about this specific show so great was because it is one season, but it's 10 episodes. I got to go so much further and live in the skin of my character longer than you get to do in an hour and a half, 2 hours in a movie. It's very, you get to take a character and watch him transform from one place to the next. So that was, I really loved the TV model for that reason, but I also really love features. I've mostly done features in my life. I have 2 movies coming out next year as well. And, that I'm the main character in, and I like that, you know, I get to play all these different characters and I don't get to locked into one.
Your character is a witness of a murder, a big, big murder at the beginning of the series. I'm not telling anything that you can see in the first 5 minutes.
It's in the first episode, don't worry. You're good.
How your character is gonna deal with that, because he has a lot of problems inside for himself, and a part of that he has lots of problems outside.
Yeah, he does not deal with it well, and as you see within the first episode, he forces Philip to keep it a secret, and that's not, you know, when you see a murder, it doesn't matter, you know, you gotta tell somebody, that's insane. But And he becomes kind of, in the first 5 episodes, he's very violent and aggressive towards Philip, but he's push and pull because he still is so attracted to him and he wants to be with this kid. And so he starts to deal with it in a better way as the season goes on, but at first it's not good.
It's coming to Spain. Tell them why they should see the series, this one and no another one, because there are thousands of series right now, and actually.
Yeah, because you know what? I know this sounds cliche to say, but you have not seen this show before, unless you live in Norway, but that's still different. It's this very much like, it's, there. You've never seen a show that takes the perspective of the killer as well as the perspective of the eyewitnesses, and you see it too. It's not a procedural, it's not a crime thriller. It's very exciting, lots of twists and turns, and I think it's truly something special, and I'm an honor to be a part of it. Please watch. Please.
Please.
More. You'll like it.
And the last one, next projects. Where are you right now? Where is James Braxton?
Yes, thank you for asking. I have 2 movies coming out next year. One is called Boogeyman Pop, and it's like a coming-of-age horror film, a punk rock horror film. And then I did another one that's a punk rock film as well, but I was the lead singer in a band, and it was set in 1990 in Texas. And I'm just, you know, looking for the next job right now. I'm chemistry reading soon in November for another part in what could be a really cool film, and I'm really hoping I get the part. So wish me luck, guys. You'll see more of me. Hola a todos los fans en España. Gracias por estar ahí. No te pierdas el estreno de Eyewitness en Calle 13, noviembre. De 8 de noviembre.
No lo sabrá nadie, porque tú atrás. ¡Debajo de la cama!
Le he visto. Estaba allí de pie, detrás suyo.
No puedes escapar.
Tenemos 3 cadáveres sin ningún testigo.
De lo que has visto.
He visto al tío de la cabaña. No podemos contarle esto a nadie. ¿Vale? No lo haré.
Próximo martes, 11:10 de la noche, Eyewitness. Estreno en exclusiva en Calle 13.